The greatest thing about being a creative person is that ideas and inspiration can strike you at any time. Maybe you're on a train when the greatest melody comes to your mind, or you're lazily lying on your couch when the urge to compose music takes hold of you. What do you do when your full-fledged 8080 keys piano keyboard is not within reach? Yeah, you rely on that little crippled 1-octave QWERTY keyboard that your DAW gives you. Well, no more. Veyboard is here to help you and make not being able to play chords and multi-octave melodies with your computer keyboard a thing of the past. Setting up Veyboard is super easy. When you run Veyboard for the very first time, this screen appears and asks you to hit, one after the other, four rows of keys in your computer keyboard. The keys before the one, then two, and so on. When the first row is done, hit Q, then W, and so on till it tells you you're done. This is to make sure that your keyboard is correctly mapped, no matter what actual keyboard in what language it is. When done, select your MIDI device and you're ready to go. If you don't have a dedicated MIDI driver, use the Mac IAC driver. To activate it, launch Audio MIDI Setup and select Show MIDI Studio from the menu. Now double-click the IAC driver icon and check the option Device in order to activate it. Select IAC driver from device menu and you're done. Finally, make sure that your DAW is accepting MIDI input from the driver. Veyboard has 6 different modes you can choose from. The simplest one is piano. In this mode, each key corresponds to a note. Even this simple mode is a huge improvement upon your DAW's QWERTY keyboard. In fact, you have access to 2.5 octaves. The first key of each octave is C, but you can shift it. You can select the velocity of your playing here. If you have an external controller, you can assign the velocity to it. For instance, in my on-the-go setup, I use Touch OSC for this purpose. Just click Assign to MIDI CC and move your controller. You can select the bass octave here. As you can see, the top two rows are the octaves you just selected, and the lower two rows of keys are an octave higher, but you can invert this behavior. If you find yourself more comfortable having the lower octave on the lower part of the keyboard, you can make this behavior permanent by checking Option Default Inverted. Another improvement upon your DAW keyboard is the ability right off the bat to add some humanization to your playing, adding slightly random changes to both velocity and the position of the played notes. Having 2 octaves is great, but what if you want to stay in key? For instance, say that you're composing a song in G major. Just select it here and here and you're ready to go. 4 octaves for you, and every note is guaranteed to be in key. You still have access to all the notes, since you can always press space and then a note, and it will play it a semitone above. If you want to save some space, just hide temporarily the options. If you want even more space, activate the stamp mode to let Veyboard on the foreground so that you can play it, but it is as tiny as a little stamp so it doesn't get in the way. One last thing before we move on. With this option here, you can hide or show the actual QWERTY keyboard value down here in case you find it useful. The second mode is fret. It works just like piano mode, but the arrangement of keys is a bit different and more similar to what you find on a guitar fretboard or a pad-based controller like Ableton Push. All chords mode lets you play, guess what, chords. You have all the major chords here and all the minor chords here. Toggling on this switch will activate the secret jazz mode. Now every bass chord you play is a 7th chord. Instant jazz. When you play chords, you can strum them or play in more open voicings. Also, auto inversions will do its best to voice the chords like a real piano player would do. For instance, playing C major and then an F major would play F over C. As always, you can choose to have all the chords of a particular key. In this case, you have access to more octaves. Chord Explorer mode is an amazing tool to experiment with harmony theory and come up with sophisticated chord progressions. Here, you have all the chords of the selected key. You can play them in any inversion, an octave higher or an octave lower. You can alter the quality of the chords, for instance, playing a suspended chord, a major 7 chord, or even something like 11 flat 9 chord. These keys give access to all the parallel modes like Dorian or Lydian, Mixolydian and so on. For instance, now I am in C major and I can access all the chords of the parallel minor scale C minor. In Chord Explorer, you can even play secondary chords, chromatic medians, chromatic submedians and the triton substitution. I'm pretty sure that playing with Chord Explorer will blow your mind and help you come up with super inventive harmonies for your songs. In hybrid piano mode, you have access to chords and single keys, as always, either chromatically or in key. When playing in the chromatic view, you can access the minor chords with the space key. When in key, you also have some of the most common chord extensions to play something a little less basic and more interesting. In this view, with the space key, you can temporarily switch the major chords to minor and the minor chords to major chords. The two sharp keys temporarily alter by a semitone the single notes or the chords. Finally, the hybrid fret mode splits the keyboard horizontally and gives you access to chords on the left and single notes on the right. As you can now guess by yourself, you can invert the views to have the notes go bottom up instead of from top to bottom, activate the diatonic 7 chords, shift the notes and also work in scale. Selecting a scale gives you access to the chords of the key. Here in C major we have C major of course and E minor, D minor and so on, plus some common chords variants. Veyboard is available right now for Mac on the App Store. Happy playing!